Need guidance about PRP treatment, please. Age 25. I'm 25 years old. Have done my first session of PRP, 31st January 2017, but there is no change in hair fall. In fact, I'm losing more hairs than before PRP on a daily basis. Medicines include Ultra Mega Gold Salmon Oil, finasteride, and minoxidil 5%. My questions are, 1. Should I go for the second session? 2. If yes, will it help me to reduce or stop hair fall? 3. Should I keep using these medicines? 4. Will there be any possible change in my hair pattern in spite of extreme shedding? 5. Will it thicken my hairs after PRP treatment?
Thank you for your question. You're 25 years old. You've submitted several photos showing the top of your scalp. And you state you had one PRP session and that you are still dealing with a lot of hair shedding. And you state that you're on finasteride, minoxidil, you're taking a fish oil, and you have basically a short list of follow-up questions. First of all, you're asking, should you go for a second session? Will a second session help reduce the hair shedding? Will there be any thickening of the hair after the next session? Will there be any change in the pattern, even though you've lost a lot of hair? Well, I understand your anxiety with this situation, as a younger person who's losing hair. I could certainly give you some guidance as to how I treat patients like yourself who come to our practice pretty much every day. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a system we developed as a non-surgical alternative to hair transplant, which ultimately has also been an alternative to the drug finasteride, which I'll discuss even further. And we have patients who come from around the world for this treatment, which has been very successful for people such as yourself. Now, to kind of go over what you've been doing, and certainly it seems like you are covering all bases. You're doing the maximal medical therapy, which is the use of finasteride as well as minoxidil. Those are the two drugs that can have any effect. And I think it's reasonable to stay on these drugs. And the reason I'm saying that is that when you're essentially your clinical picture is a younger person who is aggressively losing hair, which means the genetics is fairly aggressive. And although you've gotten one PRP injection, you're still noticing hair shedding. I think that it's important for you to understand that PRP stimulates hair growth. It doesn't necessarily stop progression. And this is probably what you are experiencing. Now, PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, has a variety of benefits, and we use it in our practice every day for a variety of uses. We use it for under-eye dark circles, we use it for acne scars, we use it for skin rejuvenations, we use it for fine lines and wrinkles. But the limitation I've seen with PRP as a standalone for hair loss is that it's basically, from, again, my experience, short-term burst of growth, but it doesn't stop progression. And so in situations like yours, we've actually developed a treatment that evolved out of doing hair transplant. And I'll explain further. We were using a material called acellular matrix to help improve the outcomes of hair transplant. Basically, the challenge in hair transplant is to make sure that maximum number of grafts survive and that the donor area heals as well as possible. Well, a serendipitous observation was that thinning hairs actually became thicker. And what I did was I decided to try to focus on developing a system to see if this was reproducible, because it wasn't necessarily happening on every patient. And my question for myself was, can we do this to help people with thinning hair and instead of doing a hair transplant? Well, it took several years of development and a lot of challenges to overcome, a lot of setbacks along the way, but essentially we've developed a system called hair regeneration. Hair regeneration does use PRP, but we use it in combination in a very specific way for different types of patients, for male, female, based on age, type of hair loss, and I do the treatment in a way to deliver the material that will actually do several things which potentially can be a benefit. Basically, stopping the progression of hair loss, reactivating and regrowing hair that is at a prolonged resting stage, as well as the inducing of shed of thinning hair so that thicker hairs grow in. Now, we do have 99% of men and women responding to this treatment. There are occasionally people who do not respond to this treatment, but in the grand scheme of solutions, it has been a remarkable development in the treatment of hair loss, which is why people come to us from around the world. I think that in a situation like yours, I would say that if you are unable to do a treatment like hair regeneration, that there is possibly some potential benefit to just following through with doing some PRP injections. But unfortunately, in my opinion, they will not be long-term value. We found that a lot of people come to us after going for PRP injections once a month, and usually at the fourth month, they get tired of doing it, and they're not sure if they're getting benefit. And you wonder, how sustainable is that? Hair regeneration for our patients has been, for the majority, overwhelmingly, has been one injection that has continued to provide stability for more than 5 years. We customize every treatment, and we've incorporated a second injection as part of the treatment to help strengthen hairs that are very fine that were literally saved from disappearing. Those hairs seem to be responsive in a lot of patients to this second injection, usually done around 15 to 18 months after the first. We refer to it as the booster injection. But comparatively speaking, there's no comparison between this treatment and PRP being done on a regular basis. So I think that, but I would say the significant and important limitation of our treatment is the inventory of hair that is salvageable. The more hair you come in with, the more hair follicles we have to work with, the better the results can be. So we advocate getting patients in who are noticing hair loss as early as possible. Right now, our youngest male patient is 17 and our youngest female patient is 16. And we have been, like I said, very, very successful with this treatment. We have to always, basically for a younger person like yourself, you're doing all the right things to try to slow down or stop your progression. But I think that if you wanted to learn more about a treatment like hair regeneration, you might find value in comparison to just standalone PRP. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. And thank you for your question. Thank you.